this video session. So in this video we are going to discuss about force exerted on stationary curved plate, that is case B we are going to discuss in this video. So that is, jet strikes the curved plate at one end tangentially and the plate is symmetrical. So let the jet strike the curved plate at one end tangentially as shown in the figure. That the curved plate is symmetrical about x-axis. So whatever the plate we consider here is symmetrical. Since the plate is symmetrical, we can say that angle made by the tangents at the two end of the plate will be same. So that is nothing but we can say the angle here and angle here, that is angle at the both ends, are same. So that is theta and this is also theta. And we can also say, if you take consider x axis here, the portion above x axis and the below x axis are same and equal. So here consider, let v is equal to velocity of the jet and theta is nothing but angle made by the jet with x axis at inlet tip of the curved plate. So consider here, this will be the theta. So same angle theta will be there at the outlet as well, since the plate is symmetrical. So let here d is equal to diameter of jet. So therefore a will be area of the jet, that is equal to pi by 4 d square. And we will consider the plate is smooth. So since the plate is smooth, there will be no loss of energy. So velocity of the water at the inlet and outlet will be equal to, both will be equal to v. So here consider, the water is entering the curved plate with a velocity v, making angle theta here. So we will resolve this velocity into two components, that is, one is in the direction of jet as v cos theta and perpendicular to the direction of jet as v sin theta. Similarly, then water leaves the vane with a velocity v here, but it is making an angle theta with the horizontal. Here also we will resolve this velocity into two components, that is v cos theta and v sin theta, that is in the direction of jet and in the direction perpendicular to the direction of jet respectively. So since the plate is symmetrical, this angle will be theta and this angle will be also theta here. So let us derive the equation for the force exerted by the jet in the direction of jet. So we'll take it as fx. So as we discussed in the previous video, so that is fx is equal to mass per second into initial velocity, nothing but velocity before striking the plate, minus final velocity, that is velocity after striking the plate. So that is mass per second. We will take it as rho into A is area into velocity into initial velocity. Just see what is the initial velocity, that is velocity with which the jet enters the plate. So you can see that is v cos theta. So that is v into v cos theta, put a minus here. Then final velocity after hitting, that is while leaving the plate. So you can see that is v cos theta, but it is in the opposite direction of jet. So we have to put here minus, and since the v cos theta is in opposite direction, you have to minus v cos theta. So we'll take here v, and v are common here. So rho into a into v square. So here, let's consider here. Here it is cos theta, minus of minus, that will be also cos theta. Cos theta plus cos theta will be 2 into cos theta. So that is fx is equal to rho into a into v square. So 2 I will write it here, into cos theta. So this will be equation for the force exerted in the direction of z. So similarly, we will derive the equation for the force exerted in the direction perpendicular to the jet. So force exerted by jet in the direction perpendicular to the jet. So we'll take it as Fy, that is mass per second into initial velocity minus final velocity. So here, so mass per second can be written as usual rho into A into V. So just look at what is the initial velocity here. In the direction perpendicular to the direction of jet. So that is nothing but V sine theta. So I will write it here. The direction is upward, so that is plus V into sine theta minus, and see what is the final velocity while leaving the wing. As you can see here, so that is V sine theta, that is also acting upward, so can substitute that, that is also V sine theta. So here you can see V sine theta minus V sine theta, that will be equal to 0. So that is 0 into rho AV, that will be equal to 0. So we can say Fy is equal to 0 in case when jet strikes the curved plate tangentially at one end when the plate is symmetrical. So we will discuss case 3 when the plate is unsymmetrical in the next video.